dark vision based people can see through, and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. Elemental Plane of Fire is basically I rip open a portal and then fire shoots out of it.
Yeah, I got that.
A portal flamethrower.
Mm-hmm.
Plane of Water is like a jet stream meant to like knock people down. So I guess the elemental ones are sort of accurate, just not necessarily in the numbers and then the saves and stuff like that. But the theme of them is accurate.
Mm-hmm.
Airplane. genius.
Okay.
The elemental plane of air, I was thinking about changing that one up. I don't necessarily know to what.
Mm-hmm.
I was thinking about like some sort of whirlwind effect or something that basically turns like arrows and like projectiles into like haha, fuck you, stuff like that. And then the elemental plane of earth is sort of would be the inverse of that. And it's like, oh, you're using melee, haha, fuck you, you can't move in this hellhole except me. So they're both like inverses of one another. The Infernal Warscape one, the Hellish one, is interesting. You actually would sort of spawn, I guess to call them totems? I don't know what to call them. Like devilish sentinels that would just sort of just, like, occupy in the ground and would attack things that are near them.
Mm-hmm.
The Divine Crossroads, if I remember correctly, would, I think it's sort of like haste, where it just makes you go faster and, like, gives you more actions for a time. The Astral Maelstrom would be like basically a psychic shunt and like a anti-spellcaster thing where it's like, oh, does this require a save? Or an attack, a spell-based attack roll is done at disadvantage for your enemies, and then all the saves you make and allies make are at advantage if they're met, if they're like spell-based.
Mm-hmm.
Let's see, the Void would literally open up a portal to the Void and then everyone would get the fucking Cthulhu treatment of, I'm gonna drag you to hell.
Oh, lovely.
And the World Spring is one you've seen with Lucy as well. It's basically like a 300-point heal distributed across however many people you want. So it's like, I have 300 hit points. I don't know if it's 300 necessarily. I think it starts at 200. I think it's higher as you guys go on. But it's like, okay, I have 200 hit points or something like that. I can distribute 200 onto one person, 100 to two people, or 99 to one person, 101 to another person, whatever fucking floats your boat.
Mm-hmm.
It's sort of like what O did during the last one job, where he just like
gave
people health.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, that's the only healing based one.
Mm-hmm.
I might change the Shadowfell run, but yeah. I only have two slots. With the World Spring or the Shadowfell.
The Shadowfell one.
Now, if Ian turns evil, it's gonna be hell to pay for someone, I'm sure. But yeah, which one sounds most interesting to you?
The what one, the World Spring and the Shadowfall one?
Those are the ones that sound interesting to you?
Yeah, well, so, to be honest, I can't actually remember.
No, which one of the list is the most interesting to you? Because I believe you only get one at level 7, so.
Oh shit, I read it wrong. Okay.
It's once per combat, you get one. Or no, you pick one right now, and then once per combat, you can pop it out. Like, use it. It takes an action. It's like a spell. A one per combat spell.
Okay, so I can't, like, sort of... Like, with the wizard, I can prepare them and change, like, switch them around?
Pick one, and that's it forever.
Okay.
So, getting the fire one, and you guys have to fight things immune to fire, would be fucking worthless. Which is, you know, pretty fair for Ranger overall. If you pick the wrong thing, you're fucked.
Okay. To be honest, I can't remember a lot of what you said. Sorry about that. So the World Spring one sounded pretty good.
Alright, then just demarcate that you have some sort of healing on you. Like, immense amounts of healing.
Okay.
And now you put more work for me this next coming week.
You know.
As you guys all do.
Where did I get this?
Speaking of picking the wrong things and getting screwed by it, we should talk about what your ranger is important. What's your favorite adversaries and what's your favorite terrain? Fuck that.
Adversaries. I was thinking, can I do just like infernals, like fiends kind of thing, or I'm trying to.
Well, there's two types of fiends. There's devils and demons. Those are.
Yeah, probably demons. Where's the list for it?
If you want to fight the Cthulhu monsters from the Void in Between Worlds, that's, you know, fair enough. There's a lot of people that don't like that sort of shit, because they're evil. And they're not even like a workable evil. Like fairies, you could make deals with. Devils, you can make deals with. Demons,
they're just there to fuck shit up.
Yeah, we're sort of here to infest your world slowly but surely, or quickly but surely. One or the other.
It says it can just, I think in a list it's saying fiends. Can I just do fiends?
No.
No, okay.
That's a PHB. I differentiate them in my game because they're two very different things.
Okay.
There's like fucking Lucifer and then Cthulhu. These are not the same thing to me. So they're two different things.
Okay. So what did you say the options were again? It was...
There's a list there in the homebrew document. Which you should be looking at. Don't look at the PHB one. We've like entirely changed it. Like it's not in anything. Oh, it's not that same anymore.
Okay. Oh, here we go. Favorite adversary. Adversary. Do you want to come back to me, or just?
Yeah, we'll come back to you. But keep in mind that before you go pick a humanoid, if you pick these things, that means you have an undying urge to kill these things, either in a psychopathic or sociopathic or other manner. All right, so like Orest is humans and elves. Why? Because he fucking hates everyone, and he doesn't mind killing any human or any elf, which is why you guys are definitely on the list. So just keep that in mind.
Okay, I'll make a list of stuff then, and then we can
just pick one.
I guess. Yeah.
And then we'll do the same thing for Natural Explorer below.
Yeah. Okay.
Switching off. Rebecca, I believe you're picking Samurai.
Correct.
I'm not racist, I'm Chinese. I can totally say that.
Wait, isn't Samurai a Japanese thing?
I'm not racist at all. I totally am. But yeah, I think you already know the ins and outs of Samurai. Do remember that we did change the number of uses for our games. You should have more fighting spirit uses and stuff like that, which I think it's like half of prof plus con, I want to say. Something like that. Boom, nailed it in one. Half of proficiency rounded down plus con modifier. Nailed it in one. But more importantly, fighting stuff. I think I already know which fighting style you're taking.
Yes. You're
taking the great weapon one? Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
I still have second wind and all that, and that much has not changed. You still have action surge, that much has not changed. For the samurai bonus proficiencies, because that actually will be important, because even though you guys are going to the hellhole of the twins, you guys will be on a mission of technical diplomacy. So, which of those bonus proficiencies there are you taking?
Wait, I gotta go look at this.
It's above fighting spirit. And you learn a language of your choice. Hey, there you go. So if you want to pick up a language, you know, you can. For any reason.
You're not completely illiterate.
So history, insight, perform. I don't know why performance is there. Performance. Oh no, alternatively, you learn a language of your choice. Okay, that's my bad.
Performance for a fighter, a gladiatorial fighter.
Yeah, but this is a samurai.
Samurai.
I don't ever remember hearing about no samurai gladiator fights, although that would be pretty funny.
And this PDF I'm using sucks.
Yeah, it's called For Honor.
Okay, touche.
Good point.
Okay, I'll give you the list. So history.
Okay.
Insight, performance, or persuasion. Or skip all those and get a language of your choice within reason. No one here is fucking getting Celestial.
Oh, disappointo.
We'll just do history, I guess.
History? There. Then demarcate that you have proficiency in the history skill. Hit that. Smash that checkbox. No, okay.
This is not YouTube.
Someday I'll play the Warlock YouTuber and then it'll be hilarious.
It'll be something.
It'll be something, all right? Yep, it'll be something.
When you say subscribe to my Patreon, it's actually Patron.
Yeah, subscribe to my Patron. You know, smash that motherfucking like button.
Oh man, this is really funny. If you want to know how far YouTube has gone downhill,
tell me.
I mean, I've been talking on that.
This is great. They actually, so you know how they do like supported YouTubers, and they'll give them like official ad spots.
They gave
this one lady, I can't remember her name. It's like Destiny something.
Destiny's Child.
No. her, I think her main characteristic is like she has ginormous titties.
So like Twitch then.
Yeah.
So well, that's where it gets better. They gave her an official ad for promoting her OnlyFans.
Oh my good lord.
I thought YouTube was family friendly. Hey, Teddy, check out my OnlyFans.
Isn't that like
Yes, it's exactly what you're about to
it's
say.
It's only for fans.
Yeah, they sell where they sell me.
Eggplant. Yeah.
Yeah, you can play a sweat drop emoji.
Why did you have to go eggplant?
Because it's true, though. Because it's true.
The internet is degenerate.
Yeah, anyways.
I think, Rebecca, you're fine, except for the 3 ASIs you get. So, decide, you like, start thinking on those. We'll go back to ASIs for everyone in a moment.
Okay.
All right, but yeah, start thinking about that, because I think you have the rest of the class down pat already. All right. Kirsty, have you decided?
Yes. So, just out of curiosity, what do monstrosities count as?
Monstrosities would be like things that are semi-natural, but are altered in some way, shape, or form. And technicality, I guess. Okay, I'll give you like the in-game list of examples. So like a phoenix, a winter wolf, like these are natural. I think a phoenix is a monstrosity.
No, yeah. That's an elemental, homie.
Oh shit, you're right. Never mind that. Winter wolf and stuff like that, you know, these things are considered monstrosities. They're natural, doppelgangers are monstrosities.
Okay, yeah.
They're so natural, like, but they have some mystical altercation to them.
If it helps you, they are the most common.
They are the most
common. Besides
by far.
Yeah. I mean, I was just gonna go. Yeah, I forgot. Let's go for monstrosities.
Monstrosities are also bad for civilization.
Yeah. Well, a lot of the things on the list are bad for civilization, like demons and devils.
This one specifically.
Yeah. So it's going to do like fiends and demons side. That's
But depending on if you guys are consistent enough with killing a certain type of foe in the Conquest campaign, I'll give you an additional favorite adversary.
Alright, time to go take out a town of dwarfs.
Yeah, let's go.
No, dwarves actually don't show up that often. I fucking know the options, motherfucker. I typed them up myself and made slides of them, so suck my dick. Anyways, let's go talk to Natural Explorer.
Okay.
There's a list of terrains there. Which one would you like?
Yeah, I'm going for the forest.
I'm fucking tired right now, man. I ain't dealing with fucking shit right now.
I love it.
I found it immensely.
I was going to do the forest one.
Classic. Same deal with Conquest. If you guys go through the same environments enough, I'll give you an additional one.
Okay.
Yep.
Swamps.
All right.
Thank you, Master.
But we're not done with you yet, because guess what? New Ranger is actually pretty complicated when we're talking about class features. You have at your set... Oh, wait, no, never mind. It's a ninth level. I'm drunk. Never mind. You're fine. I was going to say you get an additional saving throw, but one level off. Oh, well.
Rip and piss forever, miss.
Yeah. Just so you know, mark down on a sticky note to ask about favorite adversary stuff. I'm not going to remember to tell you.
And it's a lot of good stuff. You don't want to.
And monstrosities don't really have a language, so skip that bit.
Hey, Crash, quick interjection. Can I change the name of Green Flame Blade?
Yes, you can. You can change the name and then the according things of it. Yeah, it works. Going back to favorite adversary and stuff like that, Kirsty.
Mm-hmm.
If your favorite adversary attacks you, you can re-roll their attack a number of times to your wisdom modifier.
Okay.
You might just re-roll the attack. So if they attack with advantage, they still attack with advantage. It's just that maybe they won't crit you.
What?
And if you have disadvantage, you can read it there. But yeah, basically if you're disadvantage and you would have hit, you still deal a little bit of damage. So, yeah. And then there's a bunch of stuff for Natural Explorer. Most of it is pretty mundane. You can learn how many creatures are in an area, as you're tracking them and stuff like that. You always know which way is north. You can't be tricked by magic as easily, stuff like that. But the big kicker for you is a 6th level stuff.
Yeah.
So while you're in your favorite terrain, you're 10 feet. You have instead of 30, you have 40 foot movement speed. And all attacks of advantages, opportunities are made at disadvantage against you. So you basically can fucking run circles around people as you fucking run away from them. And they're just
like running away from people, so
I mean, the thing is, like, it's a bit of a wasted thing because you could just teleport through them.
Oh, I can do that. I forgot.
It takes a bonus action to do, though. So if you want to pay for bonus action for, like, more damage or something, I don't fucking... which brings me to my next point. Horizon Walker increases as you level in it. So you can blink an additional 10 feet at level... So you can... Initially, you can blink only 10 feet. So you can teleport 10 feet. By level 7, you can blink 20 feet with a bonus action. Or you can spend the same bonus action to add 2D whatever dice your weapon uses. So I think if you have a longbow, it's 2D8. Additional 2D8. Meaning if you crit... Meaning if you crit someone, that's like fucking 68.
Okay.
Or you can spend your action to teleport 60 feet if you really want to fucking run away, which would have been handy.
Very, very useful last game, yeah.
I laugh as you're the one that gave me my escape potion.
I know. I swear, as soon as you took that thing out, I was like, bastard.
You're welcome.
You should have said something.
You also have Veil Sense. That's more of an out of combat thing, but basically it's like, is there a portal nearby that opens to another realm of existence?
Yeah, I remember that.
You can detect it once per rest. You also get free spells, like automatically available spells there. So you get Protection from Good and Evil, which is pretty fucking good, and Rope Trick, which is pretty fucking shit. Yeah. It's not great. It's interesting, but it's not good.
It's thematically fun.
It's thematically fun, yeah, but... Yeah, everything else should be pretty straightforward and simple. Oh yeah, Land Stride, 8th level. You're no longer affected by difficult terrain, I believe, is what it is.
Yeah, I think I remember that, yeah.
Now, if someone has Sentinel, they can still stop in your tracks. That doesn't change. But if someone has difficult terrain up, it shouldn't affect you.
Okay.
So that 40-foot movement speed if you're traveling a forest, it's great.
You're just gonna keep reminding her subtly about last game, aren't you?
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Let's keep bringing it up. It's like, oh yeah, you got stuck in a corner.
Yeah. Fighting style, I'm assuming you're taking archery.
What was that, sorry?
I'm assuming for your fighting style, you're taking archery.
Nah, yes, go with protection. Come on.
They don't have protection.
No.
You do have ritual casting for spells, so keep that in mind. Okay. That's not a normal PHB ranger, that's an R ranger. Fuck you, Wizards of the Coast. Alright. And of course, you have your ASIs, 4th and 8th. But whatever. We'll get back to those later. So, speaking of those ASIs, though, we're going to move on to that. What'd you end up taking for your ASIs?
I only get one, and I'm not sure yet.
Okay, I'll come back to them.
That's actually the only thing I'm not sure of.
I take a +2 charisma for mine. I only get one.
Alright, you fucking multi-questing nerds. Hey. Garf, you have two.
Alright. Technically, actually, I have three, because human.
That's not an ASI, technically.
It might as well be.
Might as well be, but...
I'm not 100%, honestly.
Is no one sure about their ASIs?
Kinda.
I am.
I'm kinda caught in between of actually boosting stats or actually taking a feat. I don't think the feats are necessary for this.
It's up to you. Again, this is another point I wanted to do character creation together with JG's, is that you guys can sort of synergize and talk about this shit together. As opposed to one guy, it's like, I got Sentinel. Wait, we all took Sentinel? Whoa, that's wacky. Okay,
we'll never get past it.
How often are people going to be moving past us? We don't all need Sentinel.
Especially considering only one can activate it per movement.
Yeah.
Kind of a nice slap in the face.
I think I'll just dump all my ASIs into boosting dexterity and intelligence, because they're kind of low.
So, +2 to dex, +2 to int?
Yeah, I think that's what I'm gonna do.
Very well. Very well. Could take specialized combat. No, you already have your fighting style.
Actually,
don't
you? Do I need +2 intelligence?
Oh, yeah, take a look at the homebrew feats if you haven't looked at it.
Oh shit, I thought that was
specialized combatant can really break the game if you're a class that doesn't normally get a fighting style in the first place.
What do I do?
So, like, you have. Oh, wait, no, you already have a fighting style. You took a level 1 fighter. Never mind.
I'll just tell you what I'm going to do. All
right. So you have three ASIs. Or three? Yeah, three.
Actually, having boosted intelligence doesn't affect anything for me except for, like, save DCs and
stuff. Save DC. Bonuses.
I don't have anything that's, like, causes save DC, though.
I don't fucking know. You think I memorized that spell list?
I'll get back to you. Go back to the backup.
Alright.
You
have three ASIs.
Okay. What I did for my first one is increase strength by one, increase con by one to make them both 16.
Okay,
even and then up. I'm gonna take tenacious.
Nice, okay. So you get two, well, it's 2 times 8, so 16 more hit points. So, we haven't rolled health yet. Some of you guys already have. We'll do that afterwards. But just note that you have an additional 16 from that.
I just typed in 16 as my max HP. I'll just add the rest to it.
Weapon Master would be pretty sweet. It just adds more consistent damage across the board. It's up to you, though. Sentinel.
Yeah, I'll just take... I was trying to decide what I should take. Weapon Master.
Well, have you looked at all the feats, or are you just basically just going off my recs?
No. I did this last time when I was character creating with Garth. I'm basically just remaking my guy from our last little one-shot.
And then I kill him.
I'll just keep remaking this character forever.
Nah, I'm just gonna, like, rig it so that your strength and dex are, like, -4s or something. And then you'll have to play some other character. Okay, so you took Tenacious, Weapon Master,
D,
and then plus one to Strength, plus one to Con.
Correct.
Alright, that's your three ASIs. Bing, bam, boom. And you noted all your, like, racial feature, like, spellcast and stuff, right?
Yeah, I noticed one of my spells isn't in the 5e database, so I'm gonna have to...
No, it's not. Yeah, you gotta go look it up. Don't worry, that happens a lot! And that's why, you know, playing a spellcaster sorta isn't great. When playing on Roll 20, because Roll 20 is fucking broke as fuck. Mm. Yeah. Hey, I'm gonna throw shit at him all I want. I had to delete a lot of stuff in my, like, archive because I kept hitting the maximum because these slides have a high resolution. Surprise, surprise. So, they take up a lot of space. Yeah. So, Fred and Rebecca, the ASI is done. Curtis, to you.
Alright, I can go if you need a minute.
Yeah, I don't mind being. Go for it.
Alright, what you got,
Going Tenacious. 93 right. HP.
Holy shit. Oh, yeah, that's right, you have a high ass con, huh? Alright. Well, actually, yeah, it's pretty fair. I think 93 with Tenacious, so that's -16, so it's 77 you had before, something like that.
Mm-hmm. Exactly, yes.
Yes, that's, yeah, it's not, if you spend a fee for it, yeah. Remember the other bit of Tenacious of, like, healing and stuff? I feel like that gets forgotten a lot. So, yeah. Alright, back to you, Kirsi. He bought you approximately a minute.
Yeah, I bought a minute.
You have two.
I've already done my race one anyway, so the two ability scores.
You either take a fee or increase stats.
I mean, I'm probably going to increase stats for one of them to get rid of all these minuses. I think I might have forgotten to say earlier, but I did the triangle swap thing for some of my stats. Was that okay to do?
Did you send them to me?
I think I forgot, which is why I'm seeing.
Then send it to me now.
Okay.
I can find out. I can audit any of you guys easily. I have the chat. Yeah, I have the receipts. So don't fucking try to play me.
Yeah.
Don't mistake my compassion for weakness.
Yeah. I think it was the three, because I think there was 2 9s and then 1 13, and I swapped the...
Yeah.
Swap round. So charisma and the...
13, 16, 9, 9, another 9, and a 13, and another 13 for a reroll, which I'm assuming wisdom.
Yeah, so... Christmas now at a 9, intelligence is now at 13. And then.
Then you applied your half elf racial modifiers?
Yeah. So put my constitution up so it wasn't at minus.
Well, would you swap the stats around for? Because I noticed you have a 9 in charisma now.
Yes, so it was originally, it was constitution was a left was a 9 and charisma was a 13.
Just type it to me. Just type it to me. Just tell me which numbers got pushed where. Okay. Or which stats got pushed around.
Okay.
And then I'll double check it. It's not a two-way swap.
Yeah, but three of them were nine. Two of them were nines. So.
Oh, you're doing this before the modifiers, the racial bonuses.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, I did this all before, so I'm just not working what.
Gotcha.
So originally, it was.
So move the int to charisma.
So originally, it was nine int, nine.
If you're doing this before the racial modifiers, then it's fine. I was confused because I thought you did it afterwards. I'm like, I don't think you should.
Oh, no. 2-9
after
racial. Yeah, you know, I think I did it ages ago and I just remembered there and I was like, should have told them.
I specifically told you guys to tell me, so yeah.
Yeah.
Alright, so you move the into your charisma, gotcha. And then.
Yeah.
So now you apply the racial modifiers. Then,
yeah. So I did.
So that means your charisma should be 11, not 9.
No, I didn't put any into charisma. It was I put one into dex, no, one into con to make it a 10, and then one into wisdom to make it a 14.
It's a plus 2 to charisma and plus 2 to two other, or plus 1 to 2 other stats.
Yeah, which is what I did. I put one into 2 stats.
No, you get both.
You get both. For half elf?
Half elf gets first you put 2 in charisma, and then you put 2 in 1.
Or 1 and 2, rather.
Oh, fuck, I know what you mean. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm with you.
That's why I'm wondering when the order of this stuff, because it does matter.
Yeah.
So if you did the triangle swap after you moved your charisma stuff, it should be an 11 charisma right now.
Go away. Sorry, somebody's coming in. Go away! Right.
Is that the ninja from earlier?
No, this is the second ninja from earlier.
Okay.
Okay, so 2 should have added onto wisdom, so that should make it 15.
2 should have added to charisma, not wisdom.
Wisdom, okay. So that should make it.
No, charisma, not wisdom.
Yeah, sorry, I'm getting mixed up. So charisma's there 11. The second one was. I've got it in front. Sorry, I've just like mixed myself up everywhere. Another ability. Okay, that's fine. So that's already done. So constitution's already up. I should probably put wisdom back to 13.
You're now warranting. Okay. Well, you say okay. I'm now auditing your sheet. So give me a second.
Yeah, sorry.
Okay. Inch is
Graham still here?
13, 16, 13. What'd you put the 2+1s in?
2+1s.
From being a half elf.
Oh, I've not done that yet. So, wait, no.
No, you haven't done anything yet.
Yeah.
You put one in the con, I can see it.
Okay, I've only put one of them in. So,
what's the other one?
I'll be putting into charisma to put it up to. No, wisdom to put it up to a 14.
Alright. Then you're done.
I'm done? Okay.
So that's your racial AS. That's your racial stuff. And you have your normal ASIs, two of them.
Okay, that's just 2 points into one or
two one point points. To two or yeah. Feet.
Or feet. Okay, I'm just going to do the build to score for now. So, can I put 2 into con?
If you wish.
Yeah. And then there's one more going into.
Same stuff as before. Plus 2 to 1, plus 1 to 2, or feet.
Yeah, for another level. I haven't picked a feat yet, so I'll just do ability score improve. Yeah, I'll just put them into wisdom, so it's 16.
Okay. Your exercises are now done.
Okay, that wasn't stressful at all.
Also, you've messed up the adding of me. There you go.
Oh, sorry.
I did?
You didn't add me.
Oh.
And no, you don't get a plus one to strength for dex anymore. If it doesn't say it, then anyone don't get it. You wish.
I figured it'd be pretty fucking strong at that point.
It's already fucking broken, potentially. Oh, hi, I'm Monk, and I now do an extra, like, fucking 3 damage per punch. It's a good thing I throw, like, 5 punches a turn. Anyways, so, Garth, you have your ASIs done, yes?
Yes. I typed it into the chat.
Done. All right, you guys have all done your ASIs then.
Indeed.
Glorious.
All right, let's talk skills. You guys have your background skills already punched in, ideally.
I got all my skills sorted.
All right, let me take a peek.
I should be set up.
I got to alphabetize your guys' sheets right here.
Let's get.
No, right. You have 1 free from human. That's right.
Yeah.
Forgot that. And your criminals, I give stealth, deception. Yep. Which I always figured found it weird that criminal doesn't get sleight of hand. Oh well.
Yeah, it's odd.
All right, Jace, you got Acolyte, which should give Arcana and Religion, or some for History and Religion, rather, I believe. And 3 from Augmenter, plus 1 from being human. All right, you're good. Athletics, Intimidation for and then Insight Perception. All right. All right, let's take a look. Alright, Rebecca, what skills are you picking from Fighter? I see you already got the one from Soldier and as well as the History from Samurai. What about the rest of Fighter? You get 2.
Alright. Hold on. Come back to me.
Alright. Send over to Kirsty. So you have the 2 from your background as Outlander, which I believe is like Survival and... I don't fucking know. Let's find out. Survival and...
It's survival and athletics, I believe.
I know. Survival and athletics. You get a musical instrument tool proficiency of your choice. Mm-hmm. So bust out the lutes, the guitars, the pan flutes, the deaf whistles. I don't fucking know.
Yeah.
Mark that down somewhere.
Sticky note will do for now.
Well, put it on your sheet, I mean, because you will. That is a button that you ought to be pushing.
Yeah, I haven't picked what musical instrument I want yet, though. Unless I'm okay just to put in a musical instrument for now.
Just honestly put anything you want, as long as it's not something like modernly based, like an electric guitar or some shit, it should be fine.
Just wait. We have, like, I'm proficient in... Oh, that's not right. That's a language one.
You can put it in the tool proficiencies, because that's what it is.
Yeah, I just saw that there, I was like...
Acrobatics, Insight, Fighter, Roger.